We welcome you this evening to this Monday, Thursday service. You know, before we begin tonight, we just have a few things just to run through. As tomorrow's Good Friday, so at 5 o'clock, we'll be gathering at the field house over by the football field, and we'll be carrying the cross through the community. If you would like to join us, just walk with us. That'd be great. We will have a time of singing and scripture and some other things. So if you'd like to join us, be at the field house at 5 o'clock, okay? That evening at 7, we'll have our Good Friday service here, okay? So those are the two things, two announcements, okay? I should go on farther than that. Sunday morning, sunrise service, 6:30 in the cemetery, followed by breakfast in the fellowship hall. After that, followed by 8 o'clock service, Sunday school, and 10:15 service, okay? So we welcome you this evening in his precious name. Our goal is, in these next two nights, is to, we hope that you reshape, you know, the way you look at this whole, at these two nights of events that happen. Reshape or even refocus the way you look at these two nights and events that happen. You know, tonight we will gather and we will wash the saints' feet. We will have communion together, the Lord's Supper. So we want you to be open to what is said and what is done the next two nights. It's a little bit different tonight. The order of worship, you don't have a bulletin, so you're going to have to follow very carefully. So I did that on purpose, so you'll stay awake. Okay. No, I didn't. But it's going to be almost like a little bit of rapid fire at the beginning after the call to worship this evening. But as usual, as we say, Sunday morning, you can sit and worship, you can stand and worship, no matter what you want to do. There's going to be a mixture of different kind of music in the beginning. So there is. So we welcome this evening, I'm not used to evening service anymore. We welcome this evening in the name of Jesus Christ. We hope we feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit here, that He shapes our lives, shapes this service into what He wants to be, that His name is glorified through everything we say and everything that we do, that we get excited for what He has done for us, but also we get excited for what He is going to do with us if we only let Him. Let's worship God, ladies. As we approach the table this evening, later on this service, we will come to the table just as we are. The scriptures tell us that we need to examine ourselves in everything that we do. I just got robbed. Everything that we do, okay? So, for the opening song, Come As You Are. Eddie? I said, you can stand, you can sit, it doesn't matter. We're worshiping God. However you want to worship God, we worship God this evening.
Come out of sadness. Sorrow that heaven.
call to worship this evening is taken from Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. And it says what? I have been crucified with Christ, and it is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. And the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave up himself for me.
We have words.
My Jesus, I love thee. I know thou art mine. For thee all of folly of sin I resign.
My gracious Redeemer.
Okay. See? You took my program. Remember,
I love thee. Thy Jesus is now.
I love thee because thou dost love me. I am purchased my pardon on Calvary's tree. I love thee for we enthroned a realm of thy town. If ever I love thee, my Jesus is now. I love thee in worship. I love thee in death and praise thee.
Lendest me breath
and say, when the death do lies cold on my brow,
if
ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now.
If
ever in glory and endless delight, I ever adore thee in heaven so bright. Sing with the glitter crown on my brow. If ever I love thee, my Jesus is now. Father, we come before you. We thank you so much for this day. We thank you that we can gather within your house to be the church. We thank you we'll have the opportunity to worship you and just raise our hands and our hearts towards heaven to give you glory, praise, and honor. Father, bless us and be with us this evening, and we ask everything in your name. Amen. Jesus has an amazing love, and he showed that amazing love this whole week. A little slow.
Forsaken, I'm accepted. You were connected.
One thing that we do as we worship and as we serve, we turn our eyes upon Jesus. Turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wonderful face. And the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace. We've sung about amazing love. But there's amazing grace. Through the grace of God, we can have freedom, freedom from sin within our life. And as we sing this last one, we sing Amazing Grace. Breaks the power of sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Who shakes the whole world with holy thunder, who leaves us breathless in awe and wonder. King of glory, the King above all kings. What is it?
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That You would take my place. That You would bear my cross. You lay down.
That You've done for me. Who brings our chaos back into order? Who makes the orphan a son and daughter? The King of glory, the King of glory, who rules in nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Now what is it?
This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That You would take my place.
Thank you. be seated. It's amazing love. It's amazing grace. The grace that Christ has saved us by. And we have the opportunity to serve Him and to be with Him every step of the way. At this time, we have the ministry of music. She needs some water after singing all that.
Between a couple of thieves, the last place on earth you think He would be, but that's right where Jesus is. The Prince of Peace and perfect love, that's who He is, and where I run, I can't count the ways. He welcomes me home. He's not afraid to get mud on His robe. That's just how Jesus is.
Thank you, Jesse, very much. Hey, this evening, we know that what we're going to do. We're going to wash the saints' feet. Then we're going to have communion this evening. And we know that that Thursday evening, we call Maundy Thursday, that Jesus was in the upper room with the disciples. We've read in the scriptures, and we've read it many times, where they were reclining. He took His outer clothes off, wrapped the towel around them, and He started washing the disciples' feet. But this evening, I want to just, the time that we have, I want to talk a little bit about thanks. And this is the main thrust of everything. It said, did Jesus offer thanks for God's blessing in the past? Did He offer thanks for God's blessing in the present? Did He offer thanks for God for the blessings in the future? Three things. Past, present, and future. And on that night, we know from chapter 26, just a couple verses, that says, while they were eating, Jesus took some of the bread, and after a blessing, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. And when he had taken the cup and given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink from it, all of you. In verse 28, he stated this, for this is my blood of a covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. But I say to you, I will not drink of this fruit of the vine from now on until the day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom. In my Father's kingdom, it says. In verse 30, that's it. After they sang a hymn, they went out to Mount of Olives. On this most solemn occasion in life of our Lord, we have to remember he found it possible to be thankful to God in every way. With the agony of the cross and in his immediate future, he was offered to give thanks in every way. Our Lord had developed a habit. We all develop habits within our life, and it takes so many days to develop a habit, good or bad. But he developed a habit of giving thanks in the midst of all things and at all times. And as we observe the ordinance of the Lord's Supper, you and I have a reason to be thankful in everything that we do and everything that we say. So, did Jesus offer thanks for God's blessing in the past? As Jesus was contemplating, probably, dying on the cross, he offered thanks to God's purpose, to God. Perhaps it was thanking God for the many provisions in his ministry up to this point. Perhaps he was thanking God for the redemption purpose from the very dawn of the beginning. Perhaps he was thanking God for a divine protection of his servants through the century. Perhaps, just perhaps, he was thanking God for his abiding presence in his life. My friends, if our Lord could be thankful to God for the past, it follows that each of us can follow the same thing, can do the same thing, giving thanks to God. He has done so much for us. We can be thankful for the struggles and the sacrifices of those who are humanly responsible for the great spiritual heritage that we enjoy today. We can be thankful on this day for the prophets and the apostles, for everything they did. We can be thankful for the pioneer missionaries. We can be thankful for the spiritual forefathers. But let us be grateful during the service for God's provision in the past, for what he's done for us. But was he thankful? Was Jesus thankful for God's blessing in the present? In the present? You know, the past is easy. Because when we look back in our life, we can look back and we can see where God worked within our life. We can see where he changed our life. We can see where he protected our lives. He can see where he provided for us in every way. It's easy to look back and see everything that God has done for us. But during those times, sometimes we don't see God in that until we go through it, and it has passed. We can be certain that our Lord was living and laboring with an awareness of an abiding presence of God. Twice the voice had come from heaven declaring, "This is my beloved Son, whom I am well pleased." Jesus had come on a mission that would involve teaching. He came on a mission that would involve healing. And finally, he came on a mission that would involve dying on the cross for you and I. At this point, he was near the completion of his mission. And he thankful to God because of the joy of a personal accomplishment that took place. You know, we should search ourselves. Let us search for those things in our contemporary experience that can cause us to be thankful to God as we partake of the elements of the Lord's Supper this evening. What would our life be like? What would your life be like? What would my life be like if we never came to know Jesus? Have you ever thought about that? What would your life be like this evening if you never came to know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? My friends, we need to take an evaluation and evaluate the difference that Christ has made to enrich and improve our total human experience. We need to be grateful for the friendship, grateful for the relationships that have been made possible by his life, by his death, and by his resurrection within this world. And as we partake of these elements, Jesus symbolizes Jesus' incarnation in human flesh and his sacrificial death on the cross. Let us be thankful today, in the present, right now. Right now. There was a startling statistic, maybe you saw it the last couple days, where several years back, They took a survey on how many people go to church on an active Sunday morning. It was like 60% or something like that. They just did another one in 2024 for the first half of this year, 9.5. 30% of the people said, only 30% say they attend church on a regular basis. We need to be more thankful for what God has done for us. And when we're thankful for what God has done for us, we want to worship him. We want to praise him. We want to be with him. We want to communicate with him all the way through our life. So did he offer thanks to God for the past? Did he offer thanks to God for the present? But did he also offer thanks to God for the future? For the future. You know, with the agony awaiting him at Gethsemane and on Calvary, was our Lord anticipating a joy of return to the Father? With this element in thanksgiving that he offers to the Father, as he held in his hand the symbol of his incarnation, as he held in his hand the sacrificial death on the cross, in a great intercession, in a great prayer that's in John chapter 17, the priestly prayer we call, we hear our Lord saying this, "And now I am no more in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you." Our Lord was thankful for what in his life had taken place, his teaching, his ministry, his sacrifice, his substitute of death, and his glorious resurrection were going to mean, what they were going to mean to his followers, what they were going to mean to me, what they were going to mean to you. The writer in the book of Hebrews tells us that it was because of the joy that was set before him, that he endured the cross, despising the shame. Our Lord was offering thanks because through his coming death on the cross, it will be possible for the love of God to be revealed to a sinful race, a sinful nature, a sinful humankind. That there will be forgiveness, that there will be redemption through the blood of Jesus hanging on the cross. Our Lord was offering thanks because through his coming death on the cross, it will be possible for that love to happen. You know, as you and I partake of the bread that symbolizes Jesus coming to earth in human flesh, and as we drink of the fruit of the vine that symbolizes his sacrificial death on the cross, Let you and I rejoice. Let you and I be grateful. Let us give thanks for what Jesus' death and resurrection have done to our past, our present, and our future. Our Lord had a habit of being thankful. But the question is, what about you? Do you have a habit of being thankful each and every day? He gave verbal expressions to God and to others of his inward attitude of gratitude. This evening, as we partake of the Lord's Supper, let us be supremely thankful to him for what he has done for us in the past. Let us be thankful for what he's going to do in the present with us this evening. And let us be thankful for what he is going to do with us tomorrow morning and the rest of our life. It's through his blood that you and I have that forgiveness. In that verse 28, "For this is my blood of the covenant, which I pour out for many for forgiveness of sins." The forgiveness of sins. Let us thank him. Let us rejoice what he's done for us in every way. Amen? Amen. This evening, as we continue, the first part of this service we're going to do right now is going to be feet washing. A little different. The ladies are going to sit on this side. The gentlemen are going to sit on this side. And I believe you're going to hear some good singing tonight, a cappella. Because they'll be singing as they're washing feet. Now, I state this every time we do this. You may say this evening, you know, I'm not comfortable taking my shoes off, or I can't take my shoes off, and that's fine. I don't know if you want to wash my smelly old feet anyway. They've been in these boots quite a while. Don't get scared, guys, okay? But this evening, if you say that, if you come forward and you can leave your shoes on, if you'd like to, and we will wipe the dust off your shoes, representing feet washing in your life. So we're going to invite you to come, ladies on this side, and if there's too many ladies, we can sit on the steps, okay? But ladies on this side, men on this side, we invite you to come this evening. Let's have a word of prayer before we begin, okay? Father, we thank you. We thank you for this opportunity that you have given us to come here and kneel before each other that represents servant, to be a servant of you and to be a servant of each other. Father, bless us and be with us. Let us never forget what we're about to do. Father, we thank you for that and we ask it in your name. Amen. Father, we thank you for this opportunity that you have given us. We thank you that we can live by your example, that we can take the things that you taught us and command us to do, Lord, to live our lives and pattern our lives after you. We thank you that we can kneel before each other and we can lift each other up in prayer and we humbly come before each other. But Father, this evening, we humbly come before you. We recognize you this evening that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We recognize you as the Savior of the world, but also we recognize that you're coming back again. And Father, we're so thankful, and we praise your name for that. Father, I pray that you use us as those servants in this community, in this world that we live in. Now, Father, bless us and be with us and touch us. And Father, we ask everything in your precious name. Amen and amen. We invite you to come forward and partake of the elements. That you come down and go up the center aisle and we'll partake of them all one time. We invite you to come now. On the night of his betrayal, he took the bread and he blessed it. He has asked his Father's blessing upon it. So let's pray for the bread. Jason, please.
Father, we ask your blessing upon this bread. This bread represents the body of Jesus, your Son, broken for us, Father. We ask your blessing upon it as we partake of this together.
He said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Whenever we partake of it, we do it in remembrance of him." He took the fruit of the vine and he poured it in the cup. And imagine he raised the cup to his Father and asked his blessing, Father's blessing upon that cup. Ed, you pray for the cup.
Gracious and Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless this element that represents the blood that was sacrificed for mankind. Father, we realize that it was sacrificed for the forgiveness of our sins. Can you even imagine the love that we realize Jesus gave us by doing what he did?
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
This cup represents a new covenant. And whenever we drink of it, we do in remembrance of what he has done for us. The portion of scripture that I read from Matthew this evening said that after they had partaked of the bread and of the cup, they sang a hymn. This evening we're going to sing one of the most beautiful songs, and it's called In the Garden. Let's stand, please.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. The night arrives.
Father, we thank you for this opportunity. We thank you for this day. And Father, as we continue this very short journey through this week, we just ask your blessings upon us. Father, reshape us, remold us into what you want us to be. Now, Father, just bless us and just be with us, hold us, and care for us. And Father, we ask everything in your name. Amen and amen.